Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Good day everyone and salam sejahtera. Mudah-mudahan semua dalam keadaan yang sehat walafiat. Okay, today, continue reliability, maintenance, and reliability. Yeah, reliability we have to discuss, and we now regarding with the maintenance. Maintenance is one of the important activity in our organization, especially in manufacturing company. Okay. So basically, we have three kind of maintenance that can happen in a manufacturing company or an organization. The most maintenance that we have. Maybe we have known about this is preventive maintenance. Yeah, preventive maintenance, we can do maintenance to the equipment or to the machine, to the motor, on any tools or equipments. We can do the maintenance in terms of inspection and then service. Yeah, to keep the equipment and facilities reliable. So we want to maintain the performance on the reliability of the equipment in our organization, yeah, to function as the equipment function. So this maintenance is done routine, yeah, or regularly inspection. Usually, this maintenance followed, yeah, the guidance, yeah, from the manufacturer or from the supplier of the equipment. So the guidance to regularly routine inspection, routine the changing the oil, routine cleaning. So this followed to the supplier or to the manufacturer of the equipment. So this we call as a preventive maintenance. So this activity actually in order to avoid also, yeah, the breakdown of the equipment. Breakdown in this case is without any expectation that the equipment stop, yeah, incidentally, yeah, stop suddenly, not working suddenly. So this is the breakdown. So then we need to repair, or we need to maintenance, yeah, or we should do the big maintenance, meaning that like a overhaul, yeah, we open all the equipment and then we find out what is the root of the breakdown itself. So actually, this breakdown is not expected. It's not expected. Activities actually, yeah, because this breakdown can cause the plan or the organization not working, because this maybe like a machine, yeah, if this machine in the production line, so then the productivity will stop suddenly and will not uh, produce the product or will not running the productivity itself. So that's why we need the preventive maintenance, or we need the routine inspection, routine cleaning, routine the changing the oil, yeah, extra. So this is the two kind of maintenance that already familiar with in our maintenance, yeah, terms. Another type of maintenance is the predictive maintenance. In the predictive maintenance, and we use all of the equipment, yeah, and then we equip the equipment with the monitor that can monitor anytime, yeah. So then the, we can understand what is the condition, yeah, of the equipment in any time, and we can monitor and we can record. So the record of the equipment, the condition, so can be used, yeah, to predict what will happen for the 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, yeah, 4 years, or for the long term. So then we can prepare what should be done, what should be prepared, yeah, in order to face that the, for example, the reducing the thickness of the pipe, for example, and then we can plan when we should repair or when we should changing the pipe, yeah, if this is piping, okay. So this is the predictive maintenance. So of course, in the predictive maintenance, we need some technology, yeah, to monitor the condition of the equipment or the tools or system, yeah, in the organization. So then we can understand, we can plan the maintenance, yeah, in a certain time. So in this case, we can plan the maintenance that we are going to do, then we will not face, yeah, the sudden stop of the organization running, and then we can plan yeah, the whole plan for the productivity, for example, yeah. If we are facing the sudden breakdown of the equipment, so then this is not good if we are in the still running the productivity and then suddenly stop, yeah. We have the order, we have the purchase order from the customer, so it will be affected. But if we know when we should maintenance, then we can prepare, yeah, everything. We can postpone the order, for example, so then we cannot, we will not hurt the customer, yeah, with the information that we cannot supply or we cannot deliver it on time. So this, all of this in order to reduce the cost, yeah. So if we are facing the breakdown of the equipment, then the cost will be high, yeah, compared with we do the preventive maintenance and the predictive maintenance, okay. So actually we can have that the maintenance is a cost, yeah, maintenance is cost. If we in this figure showing the commitment of the maintenance, yeah, the commitment of maintenance, for example, commitment of preventive maintenance, for example, yeah. Of course, if the we do the preventive maintenance, yeah, and then this is also the cost. If the commitment high, and then the cost also high, because the preventive maintenance need the spare part, yeah, What else? Okay, the commitment means that if we do the preventive maintenance, for example, follow the supplier of the equipment, supplier of the tools, or manufacturer of the equipment. So they give the guidance of the maintenance schedule. At this time you should change the oil, and this time you should change the spare part. You should provide the spare part, and you should change etc. So this is the guidance from the manufacturer. So then if we do all of this, of course this is cost. If the if we have the high commitment in the maintenance, then the preventive maintenance cost will be high. So of course if we have the high commitment in the maintenance, the breakdown maintenance or a breakdown of the equipment will be lower, and then the lowering the cost of the breakdown as well. So our target break we should not have the breakdown, meaning the commitment on maintenance can be 100% commitment in the maintenance, then we can also have the breakdown cost of the maintenance will be zero. So this is the target actually. So this is the maintenance commitment versus the cost. So if we have the preventive maintenance, for example, the high commitment of the maintenance, preventive maintenance, and the increase the cost of the maintenance itself. So consequently, the breakdown will be reducing. If we commit with the maintenance, preventive maintenance cost, the breakdown maintenance will be lower. So, for example, if we have a car, then the for example, if every 1 year we change the tire, from the guidance, for example, with a certain type of tire, so we should change the four tires of two fronts and two rear, so we should change. So then to avoid any breakdown of the car, we will not have to breakdown of the tire, for example, because we change the new one. 1 year, all four tires, two front and two rears is a change. So this will be reducing the breakdown, the tire. So of the breakdown of the car. So this commitment to maintenance with this maintenance. But the question is. Should we change all four tires? So if we in the modern era, the user of the car, the knowledge and the experience will be increased. It's not only follow the guidance of the manufacturer of car, for example. We change four. Of course, this will be the performance of the car will be better. The performance of the tire will be better. But it is necessary to change all four. This is the question. If not all of the four tires not to be changed, or for example, if we understand, then there will be reducing the cost. So this the slope of the preventive maintenance cost will be it's not steep, but will be will be lower. Yeah, it's not higher, but lower. Yeah. Why? Because for example, we change only in the front tires compared to the rear tires. Yeah. Of course, we better to change with the same maker of the tire, yeah, same map of the tire, yeah, same jenama, yeah, of the tire better. But we buy, for example, the only the front tires, yeah, in 1 year, for example. After 1.5 years, then we change the rear tire. So this is the important. If we understand, yeah, the performance of the tires, yeah, we can monitor tires, yeah, the performance of tire, of the condition of tires. Why we usually the front tires we change, for example, compared to the for the rear later. This is also one of the important. Siapa boleh paham? If you have a car, why we in my case I change only on the front tire first. Siapa boleh jawab, saya bagi satu bonus atau dua bonus. Ada yang boleh jawab? Or you change all? Yeah, of course. In if you are working in organization, yeah, you should think about this one. Yeah. Of course, we have a guidance. Yeah, maintenance book from the maker or from the manufacturer of this equipment or machine, for example. But of course, with our knowledge, with our experience, with our maintenance team, so we can discuss what is the best decision that we should make. Ada yang paham? Ada yang tahu kenapa front tire and the rear tire will be having the difference in the during running in the same time 1 year, and the rear tire still in the good condition, but the front tire is a bad, I mean worse condition. Siapa boleh paham? Ada boleh paham? Saya bagi dua bonus. So this is to understand the maintenance. Maintenance is very important in our organization. So I ask you to follow, yeah, to things about this. Siapa boleh jawab? Brother biasanya. Tak ada yang paham. Dari 70 orang tak ada, 64 orang tak ada yang paham. Tak pernah guna apa kereta. Atau you never see your parents to change tire or to repair. Ada yang boleh jelaskan? Aziz Abdurrahman. Ada? Aziz ada?
Yes, Doctor.
So can you explain why? Can you explain the performance of the tire, the front tire and the rear tire or the back tire of the car?
Performance of the
Yeah, if you want to change, you change all the four tires or only back first or the front first or site first, or you change as a manufacturer of car recommendation.
Maybe
Mana
I
yang?
change. Maybe I change the front first.
Kenapa? Why?
Sebab
Hmm?
maybe yang depan tu yang guide yang tarik tayar belakang. Maybe yang cepat depan
Ya.
tu haus daripada tayar belakang.
Kenapa?
Tak tahulah
What
doktor.
happened? Ya.
Tak tahu, tak tahu.
Tak tahu. Siapa yang tahu? Saya bagi satu ini ya hasil. Yang lain. Itu tadi ikut saya kata Amirul. Amirul ada? Amirul monitor? Tak ada yang paham? Nur Atika, Nur Afika, Nur Afika ada? Halo? Halo? Nur Afika? Saya apa?
Doktor, boleh saya try jawab?
Ya, boleh. Nur Akira. Namanya tak tahu. Dia monitor.
Untuk soalan doktor tadi, saya rasa kalau kita tukar tayar ikut dia punya bunga, apa ni? Bunga tayar tu, kalau
Betul.
sikit ke kita tukar?
Ya, betul. Sekarang kalau you beli baru ya kereta sekarang.
Okay.
Kemudian setahun kemudian mana yang bunganya lebih cepat aus, lebih cepat berkurang? Atau semua sama? Semua sama, mungkin depan, belakang tayar sama.
Saya rasa belakang kot.
Belakang.
Ah.
Oke. Okay. Usual. Yang lain sama?
Doktor.
Ya, siapa ini? Saya Datul, ya.
Boleh saya cuba jawab?
Ya, boleh. Bagus.
Saya rasa tayar depan yang haus dulu.
Oh, ini dirasa atau di atau pernah pengalaman ganti? Ya, itu masalahnya. Kenapa
tak,
depan?
Tak, saya pun tidak lesen, doktor.
Ya, oke. Okay. You can tengok siapa apa ayah ataupun emak ya yang ganti. Kenapa? Tapi apa tak perasan hanya ganti-ganti saja begitu?
Tak perasan, doktor. Tapi saya rasa depan lah.
Kenapa?
Sebabnya kalau ikut logik lah, doktor, kan enjin dekat depan, penumpang pun selalu di depan. Jadi geseran pun di depan lah, doktor, kan.
Okay, hampir ini, hampir. Nur Atirah sama saya Datuk bagi satu juga. Ada yang nak dua, siapa lagi? Dan yang apa-apa pilihan dan juga reason. Correct. Ada lagi? Tak ada. Kalau tak ada, apa?
Saya
ya,
nak
Nur Sabrina, macam mana?
Sebab tayar depan tu yang mengemudikan kereta tu, kita kontrol kereta melalui tayar depan. Sebab tu kena tukar depan dulu, yang lama ganti ke belakang.
Yang lama?
Usually kalau kita tukar tayar baru dekat kita pasang dekat depan, yang tayar lama ganti dekat belakang.
Tayar lama yang mana? Tayar tayar depan ganti baru, kemudian tayar depan ganti belakang.
Iya.
Macam mana kan ke tayar depan yang rusak, yang cepat yang aus, kenapa disimpan dekat belakang? Di belakang tetap saja kan. Tak payah ganti. Atau maksud you yang depan belakang ganti depan, yang depan ganti belakang begitu?
No, tak, bukan.
Terus?
Maksudnya tayar depan yang ganti dengan tayar baru.
Terus? Itu sahaja kan?
Sebab tayar depan dia yang mengemudi tayar belakang.
Okey. Ya, itu ya saya bagi dua lah ya, walaupun I can explain, saya boleh jelaskan ya. Tayar depan, kenapa tayar depan dia aus lebih dahulu? Karena dia driven. Baik, engine di depan akan berbeza kalau kita ada namanya four wheel driver. Pernah dengar 4WD?
Pernah.
Nah, kalau 4WD semua driven baik front and back. Itu semua kalau kita tayar depan dia driven by engine in the front, artinya apa? Bahwa tayar will be loaded ya, akan berpusing sehingga dia beban lebih besar daripada yang di belakang. Beban apa? Beban friction. Nah, itu. Jadi sehingga kita boleh beli dua saja di paling depan, karena kalau depan saja yang kita ganti, artinya kita jimat, bukan? Jimat cost, maintenance cost. Akan lebih jimat lagi kalau kita berpikir yang depan itu aus, yang belakang masih bagus. Nah, kita ganti yang depan ganti belakang, yang belakang ganti ke depan, sehingga at the same time. Ya, we can have the same condition. Ya, jadi depan dan belakang sama kondisinya, tapi maintenance ataupun change ya, kita tak payah beli yang baru. Nah, ini lebih cost lebih reduce lagi. Artinya apa? The preventive maintenance ya, cost will be lower. Kalau ikut daripada guidance dari OEM, dari manufacturer, kita ganti semua, depan ganti, belakang ganti. Of course, itu better, the best one, tapi cost kan. Kalau kita tidak kaya ya sendiri, okelah, tak masalah. Tapi kalau di dalam suatu organization, we should optimize the maintenance. So then we can reduce the cost. If we can reducing the cost, so the total cost will be lower. Ya, tadi talk salah the simple example, ya, changing tire. Then changing tire for car. If we follow that guidance, we change all, so the cost is high. But if we understand that the tire, the front tire is the worst compared to the back tire, so only the front tire we change. And this is they will be reduce the cost. Yeah. Yang semula kita beli 4, ya kita beli 2 saja. Tapi if we smart, ya. Of course, we should responsible also, ya. That we change yang tayar belakang ganti tayar depan, yang tayar depan ganti ke tayar belakang. So then, this is the way. So then, we should not buy any new tire. So then, maintenance cost will be much lower. So this is the important. Okay. Then we can save yeah the cost. Yeah, in this case, for example, this is the original preventive maintenance cost. Yeah, in traditional view, yeah, as we have discussed that this is the commitment of maintenance, preventive maintenance. Yeah, increase, of course, the cost will be increased. Consequently, increasing the preventive maintenance cost will be reducing the breakdown maintenance cost, because we should not have the breakdown equipment. Itu. So then we have two graph here, yeah, preventive maintenance and breakdown maintenance, so that we can have the optimal point, the lowest cost, yeah, maintenance policy here. Yeah, so this is the lowest cost. So then we should put, yeah, here we should put the preventive maintenance cost in this location. Yeah, so the breakdown cost will be in this cell. So that the total cost will be here. Yeah. So this is the total cost of maintenance. Traditionally, if we follow the guidance of the manufacturer, but if we in the modern, so that we can save just now, yeah, we can save the total cost, we can save the preventive maintenance cost, and we can come to the maximum maintenance commitment to the. For example, in this 100%, for example, in here, so meaning that the we should not have the breakdown. Yeah, we should not have the breakdown. Yeah, so that the breakdown cost will be the lowest one. Then we can have the total cost. Yeah, shifting just now in the here, yeah, higher. Then we can have the total cost will be lower because we can lowering the preventive maintenance. Jelas ya. So then the slope of the preventive maintenance we can reducing by knowing the performance of the performance of the equipment. Yeah. So the how can we know the performance of the equipment actually? Yeah. How can we know the performance equipment? For example, in this case, how we can we know the performance of the tire? Of course, visually we can see. Yeah, for example, just now, bunga tayar, for example, sebagai indikator untuk mengetahui apakah tayar tersebut masih bagus atau tidak. Eh, bunga tayar masih nampak, itu adalah bahwa tayar boleh digunakan semula. Tapi kalau punya bunga tayar sudah tak nampak, kemudian ada the metal, yeah, from the inside of the tire comes out. This is we should change the tire. So then, if we understand more, we have the front tire and rear tire of the car. Then what is the performance? Yeah, in the rear tire, we should not have any rotating the load, but the only. The vertical load, yeah, from the weight of the car on and passenger, for example. But the front, both width and weight of the car and the passenger, and then the, also the friction of the rotating, because the driven of tire is coming from the front, yeah, because engine in the front, and then the tire will be. Receiving the rotating force, yeah. It is different if we have a four-wheel driver. So the rotating force will be front and rear. So this is the condition of the tire will be same in the same time. So this is the additional of the knowledge, yeah, that we can take the action whether we should buy. New or not, or we just change the front to the rear, rear to the front of the tire. You know, then we'll be shifting the cost, yeah, because recommendation to buy the new one, but you decide not to buy new, you exchange front and rear, so they will be shifting, and then the total cost will be lower. This is very important in the organization. If you don't understand the performance of the equipment, you should decide whether you change a new spare part or we just exchange or we just cleaning the equipment. Yeah, so then you can improve again the performance of the equipment. Yeah, without any increasing the cost of the maintenance. And this is important. The important, yeah, of course. How can we understand in the organization? So that we have the computerized maintenance system. So the all of the data, yeah, from the equipment. For example, yeah, equipment file with the parts list, maintenance and work order schedule, repair history file, etc. So this as an input, and then we can have the output report. The output report is used whether we should take action, whether we should do the repair, we should do the cleaning, we should do the changing the new spare part, for example. So this is the output report. So then all of this data is very important, and then also the output report such a the alternative solution, yeah, to decide whether the equipment should be changed, the whole or only spare part we change, or just we just clean. So this is important. Of course, this is also and take action for the periodic maintenance. Yeah, it's not we should refer also to the refer to the guidance from the manufacturer, but also all of this depends on our decision whether we can maintain the equipment running smoothly, and then the operator also feel the self of belonging to the equipment, so they can take care the equipment very well. That is the decision, yeah, can be made in order to lowering the cost without any troubling, yeah, without any breakdown happen, yeah, to the equipment. So this is the maintenance cost, and this is example, yeah, maintenance cost example, yeah. For example, the number of breakdown and the number of month that breakdown occur. For example, 2 months, the first 2 months there is no any breakdown, for example, yeah, and the breakdown happen once, yeah, after 8 months. And then after that, 6 months later, 2 breakdown. And then 3 breakdown happen after 4 months later. So the total operation is 20 months, for example. And then the average cost of breakdown is $300 per month, $300 per month. Then now compute the expected number of the breakdown. Monthly, yeah, in this case. So what is the expected number of breakdown monthly? If we have the such this data, yeah, then what is the number of the breakdown monthly? And this is we have a number of breakdown zero, yeah, 2 months over 20 months operation, so 0.1. The breakdown number is 1 times after 8 months. So this is the frequency after 8/20, so 0.4 extra. Yeah, 2 breakdowns happen, yeah, for 6 months later. So this is the frequency is 0.3, and 3 breakdowns is 0.2. So this is the expecting number of breakdown is number of breakdown multiplied by corresponding frequency, the sum of all of this. Yeah. So then we can have the 1.6 breakdown per month. This is the average. The average is 1.6 breakdown per month. So this in this case without any preventive maintenance. So then we can have 1.6 breakdown per month. For example, after 20 months of the operation, so we have in our calculation that we have 1.6 breakdown per month. Meaning that we have, for example, the average cost of breakdown is 300. So in this case, we have 1.6 breakdown per month. So then we have the actual and the cost, yeah, of breakdown is $480 dollar per month. Why? Because the actual one is 1.6. So then we our expectation is per month is 300, but then it happened from with beyond of the expectation, so 1.6 breakdown per month. So then the cost will be higher for 180 dollar per month. Now, what happened if we have our preventive maintenance? If we have the preventive maintenance, before that, during 18 months, we do not have any preventive maintenance. Yeah? So that breakdown happened. So the breakdown happened, then the will be cost. Yeah? And then if we do the preventive maintenance, what happened? With the preventive maintenance, yeah, so the we do the service to the, our equipment. So per month is 150 per month, for example. So then we can have the cost of maintenance is 450. So meaning that 300 plus 150, so $150 per month. So this is less expensive than without any preventive maintenance. So this is the explanation of our graph here. Yeah. This is the preventive maintenance. Yeah. So without the preventive maintenance, it will be higher. So then, how can we have the to maintain in the preventive maintenance? And so then, we should have the what we should do in organization. For example, some action that we can we should improve or we should have. For example, when train personnel, yeah, that we send the personnel for the training. Yeah, we should not hire the third party to repair our or to service our equipment. Of course, then we can we should have the adequate resources. Yeah. Resources in this case it can be facilities, yeah, to repair or to maintenance, yeah, and also the spare part, the ability to establish the repair plan and priorities. The priorities in this case, we should have the knowledge and the experience. Just now about the tire, for example, and this is also can be applied for other equipment. The ability to authorize to do material planning, which one the spare part that we should buy. Ability to identify the cause of the breakdown. Yeah? This is the knowledge. The ability to design way to extend MTBF, yeah? Mean time between failure. So this is to extend the mean time between failure. So then we can reducing the occurrence of the breakdown. This is increasing the repair capability. Yeah, and we increase the and we and the competence height, yeah, and then the preventive maintenance will be lower. Yeah. Of course, in the preventive maintenance also we can equip with the autonomous maintenance. Yeah. So the autonomous maintenance, in this case, in order to employ to accept responsibility for observe, yeah, for the check, or adjust, or the clean, or the notification. So this, all of this, in order to predict failures, to prevent breakdowns, and prolong the equipment life. And in order to improve our quality of maintenance, so this TPM, yeah, total productive maintenance, very important. So what is the total productive maintenance? So in this case, if we improve in the design of the machine, so we should make the machine to be more reliable. meaning that easy to operate and easy to maintain. Yeah, it's not complicated of the machine. So then, and then also not reliable. But sometimes reliability and the operation, easy to operate and easy to maintain, this is sometimes contradictory. Yeah? Like in Japanese equipment. Yeah? It's very high reliability, but it's not easy to maintain. If something happened and then change it. This is different with the Western style, yeah, in the past, yeah, but today maybe only on same. Yeah. On the American equipment, is the reliability is lower, but maintenance is easy to maintain, easy to open all the equipment so that you can easy to maintenance, yeah, and easy to operate. Yeah. And this is the in Japanese easy to operate but difficult to maintenance. Yeah. This is like a black box. Yeah. And Americans, we can open and we can see and we can clean, we can maintain. So, but total productive maintenance is how to design. If we improve the design machine, we should make the reliable, high reliability, easy to operate and easy to. And then the second one, the emphasizing total cost of ownership. Yeah. So this, if we buy the machine, we should include the service and maintenance, yeah, and the cost of the price of the equipment. So this is the important because manufacturer usually offer, yeah, the maintenance or the service for a certain time. For example, if the guarantee 3 years, yeah. So then you can get any free or for charge in service and maintenance, for example. So then you can learn from that how to maintain, how to service the equipment that we have. So this is the ownership of a machine. It's very important, yeah. So sometimes we buy the machine, but we cannot have the ownership of our machine because we cannot do the maintenance, we cannot do the service. And this is, it depends on the manufacturer to come to repair. And this is then the cost will be high. Yeah? So this is the total productive maintenance. Yeah. Improve the design. We should make the machine reliable, easy to operate, and easy to maintain. And then the ownership. We should improve our ownership, the machine that we purchase by. Improving the service and maintenance, yeah, and the price. And then the third is developing preventive maintenance plans that utilize the best practice of the operators, maintenance department, and the people service. Yeah. So total productive maintenance recommend to have the maintenance plan. Yeah. So this is guided by the manufacturer. So then we can have the maintenance plan. The maintenance plan can be same or can be improvement. Yeah, with our knowledge, yeah, our experience, so we can change. But we should have the plans. So then we make sure that the maintenance is done properly. And then the fourth, yeah, total productive maintenance is important as well as training for the autonomous maintenance. So operator maintain their own machine. So this is important in order to improve our capability to maintain our equipment. So this is for the total productive maintenance. Then the important as well is the providing redundancy, as we have discussed last time about the reliability of the equipment. So by providing the redundancy. Yeah, by providing the redundancy, so we can improve the reliability of the equipment. Yeah, so this is, for example, one pump have the reliability 0.8. If we have the redundant plant pump, yeah, equipped or installed, so then we can improve from 0.8 to the 0.96. So this is improve the reliability. So of course, the improving the reliability is one of the commitment. Increasing the commitment, yeah, and the maintenance. So then improving the commitment, of course, this is high cost, so reducing the breakdown of the equipment. Yeah, this is the some problems with breakdown maintenance. So there are two possibility of the to facing the breakdown. Yeah, the first run it till it breaks. Run it till it breaks. So this means that we run the equipment until the equipment breakdown. Yeah, so this is the of course this is the might be okay for low critical equipment. For the low critical equipment, it's okay. You just operate until breakdown. But for the main equipment, this is problem. If like a fuse, 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 right? Fuse is to limit the current, electric. Yeah. If we you should not change the fuse, you should not change the fuse until it breaks. Yes, you change also okay, but if not critical, then what for? Better at break then you change something like that. So this is the breakdown. Or fix it, whether or not it is broken. Just now, if the fuse, whether it's broken or not, you change because already long time. For example, you just I feel feeling good, better if I change this fuse. It's okay as well, but this is not this if this is not critical, then this is cost. So this is the part of the how to maintain equipment based on the critical part or not. If the critical part, we should fix it. If not critical, maybe just running and then until broken and then you change because it's not critical. So this is the for the breakdown. And another strategy of the maintenance is predictive maintenance. What is the predictive maintenance? The predictive maintenance, so we can, of course, we can predict what will happen at, for a certain time, as we have discussed, 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 3 years. So this the predictive maintenance is important if we have accurate data, accurate experience data, experience data from the running of the equipment or system at a certain time. So we monitor what is the trend actually, like pipe, for example, piping and then oil and gas, so pipe to flow the oil or gas. So there is the friction between oil or gas or any mix up there, with the pipe. So then the pipe will be corroded. Yeah, the corrosion of the pipe, it will be make a pipe becoming thinner and thinner. It's not thick, but thick and thinner and thinner. So then from this we can predict. We can predict when the pipe should be repaired, when the pipe should be changed. So then, how can we have this kind of data? Of course, we should have the monitor. Monitor of what? Monitor of the diameter, inner diameter, for example. Or we should have the sensor. The sensor in order to monitor the thickness of the pipe, for example. Or we can have the by the reaction, on the corrosion. The corrosion rate, for example, if we can have the corrosion rate of a certain pipe with a certain kind of fluid, so then we can predict when the pipe should be repaired, when the pipe should be changed. So this is the like a visual inspection, scheduled measurement of a vibration, temperature, oil, and water quality. So this is a parameter that we can predict the performance of the equipment, the performance of the tools, the performance of machine. So this we can compare with the original or the healthy baseline. Yeah. So then if we already beyond of the healthy baseline, then we should maintenance, basically whether we repair or we change the type. Yeah, and other equipment change the spare part. So this is the predictive maintenance. So then we should have the equipment such as a sensor of a sensor of temperature, sensor of the vibration, sensor of the pressure, or quality of the fluid. And so this is the of the equipment that we use for the gathering the data of the equipment or tools. So this all of this equipment, for the vibration analysis, so it's very important. Infrared thermography also important to understand the hot spot. If the hot of the for example vessel is not, it's not predicted, and then maybe in there will be. Having the defect, for example, so then we can understand to the action or to plan what will be done for the maintenance. All of this regarding with the sensor, ultrasonic wave sensor. This also to predict the corrosion, for example, with the ultrasonic, so we can detect the defect inside of the metal. And then the development of the defect can be predicted. So then we can predict when when the equipment or the pipe will be breakdown. So this is the using the tools, ultrasonic sensor. So the comparison between maintenance strategy, breakdown, preventive, and predictive. So this is the for example breakdown the advantage, no prior work required. Yeah, breakdown because we do not know just running and then breakdown. So no prior work required. The preventive work can be scheduled, periodically the maintenance of the clean, we change the oil, etc. In the predictive, the impending failures can be detected and work scheduled. So this, all of the data of the operation of the equipment or tools, so then we can predict, we can expect when the maintenance that we should be done. And then, of course, there is the disadvantages, the cost. And preventive, especially and predictive, the labor cost there. And the disadvantage in the breakdown is suddenly happen, can be injury or can be death, kill the operator. So this is the maintenance strategy implementation. And we have a predictive maintenance, so you can reduce the cost. The percentage of the percentage of the cost of the maintenance, predictive, we can have to predict until 10 years. Preventive, of course, the preventive, the percentage is remain same all the time because the periodically done. In the breakdown, if we do the preventive, we can reduce the breakdown as well as we improve the predictive maintenance. Yes. So that the breakdown into the next years, the couple of years, so we can reduce it. Yeah. Now, of course, the predictive maintenance, we can have the illustration. In most industry, the average rate of return is 7 to 1. Yeah. Compared to 35 to 1 for each predictive maintenance lifespan. So you can imagine In this costly vibration analysis, IR tomography and oil water analysis are economically proven technology that we can reduce the cost. If without any predictive maintenance, so they can break down and will be much more the cost can happen. So by this maintenance, predictive maintenance, so that we can improve the effect, the reliability, so that we can have the effective reliability. So the effective reliability further can be calculated from the failure, the probability of failure multiplied by the probability not detecting failure. Yeah. So 1 minus predictive failure, so this probability of failure is 1 minus reliability. Yeah. If reliability 0.8, so the failure probability is 0.2. And then detecting failure, for example, 70%, so not detecting failure is 0.3. And then we can calculate the effective reliability. This like this example. Yeah. In this example, for example, yeah, large gearbox reliability is 0.9. If we have the we can have the predictive maintenance, and then we can predict and the probability early detection of the failure is 0.7%. Okay? So then the what is the effective reliability? We can improve from 90% to the 97%. Okay? So this is the important. Yeah. So what is the equipment that we use? Yeah, the vibration sensor. We can monitor vibration so that we can predict the failure. So then improve the effective reliability. So in order to increase the capability of the repair, we send the personnel to train, and the adequate resources and proper application of three maintenance strategies as well, predictive, breakdown, and then the regularly maintenance. Yeah. And continue improvement to improve equipment or system reliability. Yeah, so this is the way the maintenance, and then we have redundancy of the system to improve the reliability, so then we can continue improvement, yeah. And then we can increase. Yeah. We can improve our quality improvement. By improving the maintenance, so then we can improve the quality of the. We can improve the quality. Okay. So this is the all of this maintenance and reliability. We are hopefully beneficial for you. Thank you. Any question? Any question? Okay, if you have no any question, so I end this class and we continue next test day. So thank you for your attention for today. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Jaga kesehatan ya.
Thank you, Dr.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr.
Thank you, Dr.
Okay.